Hello students, today we will discuss lenses. Dear students, you already know that a mirror, convex and a concave mirror, and a relation between F and R, and another thing, image position and object position, and how to formation of images, and these all things you already know that. So today we will discuss about lenses. Here the first one, mainly we consider that two types of lenses are there. One is a convex, another one is a concave lens. Okay, so first one is a convex lens. Okay, so convex lens, so convex lens, so middle part is thick and edges are thinner. Whenever the parallel beam of a light rays passes through this convex lens, then what happens? So this light ray is convergent. Yes, it means, so convex lens always produce a converging beam of a light when light ray passes through it. Another one is a concave lens. Okay, so this one is concave lens. So middle part is thin and edges are thicker. And so this lens always produce diverging beam of a light. Yes, when parallel beam of a light passes through this concave lens. When parallel beam of a light passes through this concave lens, and it is produce a diverging beam of a light. And suppose here we consider that, so this one is a midpoint of a lens. So this one we consider that optic center. It's make incident ray and a refracted light rays, both are parallel. And here another one thing, and this one we consider that aperture. So aperture is always perpendicular to the principal axis. And this point we consider that principal focus. Yes, it means, so refracted light rays meeting at a point on a principal axis. So this one is a principal focus, F. The distance between principal focus to optic center, so this one we consider that a focal length. And here also same thing, so this one we consider that a principal focus, and this one is a optic center, and these are we consider that a parallel beam of a light rays, and this one we consider that a normal. Yes, so this, it means this optic center makes a incident ray and a refracted ray, so parallel. So that's when we consider that a optic center. Yes, and here also we consider that a distance between principal focus to optic center. So this distance is a focal length. And here, suppose, so this convex lens made up of two helospheres. For example, here we consider that so this one is a one helosphere, and another one we consider that, so this one is also one helosphere. Yes, and these two we consider that center of this helosphere. Yes, it means center of a helosphere, and this one we consider that a part of the helosphere. It means also this one we consider that a convex lens. The distance between optic center to center of a curvature, yes, so this one we consider that a radius of a curvature, and here also we get a radius of a curvature R. Okay, the distance between center, it means center of a curvature, suppose if we consider that this one is a halosphere, and here we get a center. of a curvature. So distance between optic center to center of a curvature, so this distance we consider that a radius of a curvature. And here also same thing, so this one is one sphere and here also one sphere, and somewhere we get a center of a curvature. Yes. So next one, suppose here in convex lens we consider that a two focal length. Why? Because suppose here, so this one is a lens, okay, so this one we consider that length, and these are parallel beam of a light rays. When parallel beam of a light rays passes through this convex lens and these light rays meeting at a single point on a principal axis, so this one we consider that a focus, it means a principal focus. Okay, so here suppose, so this one is a sphere and this one is another sphere, here we get a center of a curvature and here also we get a center of a curvature. See, yes, okay, you already know that radius of curvature is nothing but a 2 times of a focal length. Radius of curvature is nothing but a 2 times of a focal length. Okay, so optic center to this center of curvature we consider that a radius of curvature, and here also we consider that another radius of a curvature. So radius of curvature is nothing but a 2 times of a focal length. So this reason, so this point we consider that a 2f, and this one is also we consider that a 2f. Yes, why here C is we consider that a 2f? Because so R, it means radius of curvature is nothing but a 2 times of a focal length. So this reason, these two position we consider that a 2f position. And here suppose a light rays, so these are we consider that incident light rays, and passes through this lens and meeting at a single point, and here we get a F position, it means a principal focus. The same thing, so number of light rays passes through this convex lens. Then what happens? So these light rays meeting at a single point, and here we get a principal focus. Yes, so here we consider that F, and here also F, and this one is a 2F position, and this one is also we consider that a 2F position. So this 2F position is nothing but a radius of curvature, it means a point C. Okay, suppose you already know that a real image and a virtual image. So how to form a real image? It means when a reflected or a refracted light rays are crosses to each other or intersect to each other, so here we get a real image, and a real image is always inverted, and a real image is easily caught on the screen. Another one is a virtual image. Yes, so diverging beam of a light rays produce virtual image, it cannot caught on the screen, and another thing, it is always erect, it means as it is. Okay, so here we discuss about position of object and formation of image. Suppose, so this one we consider that a convex lens, and object, it is placed at an infinite distance. Object position we consider that a infinity. Object position we consider that a infinity. It means, so these light rays come from infinite distance. Why? Because somewhere we will get object, so these light rays came from object. So this reason, object position we consider that infinity. Okay, so these are parallel beam of a light rays meeting at a single point on a principal axis, so this one we consider that a F, principal focus. So here we get image. So here we get image, so this one is a real image. Why? Because so refracted light rays are crosses to each other. Okay, so here we get image at a F in a position. Image at a F in position. So this image we consider that a real image. So this one is a real image. Yes, so size of a image we consider that a point in size. It means a very small in size. So this reason, so size of a image is a point in size. And magnification, we consider that a magnification object. You already know that formula, magnification m is equal to minus v divided by u. S, suppose object distance we consider that infinity and image we get exact f in position. It means, so image distance we consider that v, it means we get a 0, it means a point in size, it means a diminished, very small. Yes, it means size of image is, if you compare to object size and image size, yes, size of image is less than the size of a object. Why? Because we get a point in size of image. So magnification value is less than 1. Yes, it means we consider that as 0. Anything by infinity is 0. So this reason 0. It means we consider that a point in size or very diminished, very small in size. And the next one, suppose object is placed. Suppose here we consider that a F position. And here also F position. And here 2F. 2F is nothing but C. S and here also 2F. Suppose object placed beyond C or beyond 2F position. Okay, so beyond 2F position. So this one is a object. And incident ray came from this object and this light ray is a refracted. Yes. And another one light ray. So this one we consider that normal. So this is a normal passes through this optic center and here, so these two light rays are crosses to each other. Yes, and here we get the image. So this image is a real image. Why? Because inverted. Okay, so object position we consider that beyond 2F. Yes, object position is beyond 2F. Then we get the image in between F and 2F. In between F and 2F. Yes, and this one is a real image. Yes, so this one is a real image and size of image is less than the size of object. Size of image is less than the size of a object. And magnification value, so magnification V M is equal to minus V divided by U. Okay, so object position we consider that beyond 2F position and image we get in between F and 2F position. So this reason magnification value is less than 1. Suppose if you consider that modulus, it means less than 1. So less than 1 means, so this one we consider that a diminished image. It means a small in size compared to object. Another one, suppose object is placed exact 2F position. So F and here also F and here 2F and here also, so this one is a 2F. Suppose object placed exact 2F in position. Yes, so incident ray, so this light ray is refracted and this one we consider that a normal. Okay, okay, so here these light rays are crosses to each other exact 2F in position. Okay, so this one is object placed at 2F position and image also we will get in a 2F position. Okay, so image position we consider that it is exact 2F position and the size of image is equal to the size of object. Yes, size of image is equal to the size of object and this one is a real and inverted. Real and inverted and magnification value is equal to 1. Yes, so magnification value is equal to 1 means size of image is equal to the size of object. Another one, suppose ऑब्जेक्ट प्लेस्ड इन बिटवीन एफ एंड टू एफ पोजिशन. ओके सो दिस वन इज अ टू एफ and this one is a F position here also. So this one is a F position and this one is a 2F position. Suppose object placed in between 2F and a F position. Okay, incident ray, and here we get a refracted light ray, and this one we consider that a normal. Okay, so here, so refracted ray and the normal light ray crosses to each other. It means we here we get a real image, and the size of image is greater than the size of object. Size of image is greater than the size of object, and here we get a image beyond 2F position. Why? Because object placed in between 2F and F position, then we get the image beyond 2F position, and magnification value is greater than 1. Magnification value greater than 1. So this reason, so size of image is greater than a size of a object, and this one is a real and a inverted. Okay, next one. Suppose object placed exact F in a position. Okay, so F, 2F, F and 2F. Suppose object placed exact F in a position. Okay, incident ray and refracted ray, and this one we consider that a normal. Okay, so object placed exact F in position, then we get a image at infinite distance. Image at infinite distance, and this one is a real image, and the size of image is greater than the size of object. So this one is a real and an inverted image. And suppose object placed in between, so this one is optic center O, and this one is a focal length, sorry, principal focus F, and this one is also F, and here we consider that 2F. Suppose object placed in between F and O, it means in between focus and optic center. Okay, incident ray S, and here we consider that a refracted ray, and this one is a normal. Okay, so here we get the image. So this image is a virtual and erect image, and here we get the image in the same side of a object. So this one is a object and this one is a image. So image we will get in a same side of a object. You know that mirrors. In mirrors, when object placed in between F and P position, then we get a image another side of a mirror. The same thing. So here object placed in between F and O, then we get a image in the same side of a object, and this one is a virtual image and erect. Okay, and another one, suppose if you consider that concave lenses. And here, object placed at an infinite distance, and these light rays passes through this concave lens, then what happens? So these light rays are refracted. It means, so here we get a diverging beam of a light. Okay, if you extend these light rays, S, and here we get an image. S, and this image is a very small, it means a point in size. Suppose another one thing, suppose here object placed in between F and O, in between F and O, then what happens? Suppose here we consider that this one is an object and these are incident light rays. S, so this light ray is refracted, and this one is a normal, and here we get the image. So this one is a virtual image, and the size of image is smaller than the size of a object. Yes, so this one is a virtual and a erect. Okay, so next one, you already know that sign convention. In mirror concept. Here also sign convention concept is there. So same concept. Here also we consider that a same concept. Suppose, so this one is a convex lens, principal axis, and this one is a optic center. And here, so this one is a direction of incident. Always we consider that a direction of incident left to right side. Okay, so direction of incident. And this one is opposite to the direction of incident ray. Okay, and this one is the object. And somewhere we get a image. Okay. So here, and optic center to object. Optic center to object, we consider that object distance, optic center to image. So this one is a image distance. Okay, so first condition. If you measure any distance, if you consider that object, otherwise image, is if you measure any distance from optic center of a lens, from optic center of a lens. Okay, so this one is a first condition. And the second one, if you measure distance along the incident ray, measure the distance along the incident ray is a positive. Along the incident ray is a positive. For example, okay, so this one is the direction of incident, and here we consider that image. Here we get the image. Okay, if you measure distance always from optic center, always from optic center, so this reason, so optic center to image, so this one is present along the direction of incident ray, so this reason, so this one we consider that positive. Suppose optic center to image, so this one is opposite to the incident ray, so this reason, so this one we consider that a negative. Yes, so if you measure the distance opposite to the incident ray, so that's one is a negative. Along the incident ray, so that's one is a positive. And here size of a object, it means, so in upper side, so this one we consider that positive, and inverted, so this one we consider that a negative. It means upside we consider that positive, and lower side, it means a downside, we consider that a negative. Yes, okay, so this one